Welcome to the pod where black magic happens.
This is the future of shipping, and I'm sure even the ships will get driverless very soon.
But these are moving by themselves, no drivers.
What's up guys, welcome back to another day at sea, and we are currently in North Sea heading towards Rotterdam from Antwerp. It has been an extremely tiring coastal, but this is going to be our last port here in Europe. The special thing about Rotterdam is it has got unmanned vehicles for picking up containers. So that is something I want to show you all in this particular video. Currently we are in the North Sea and the weather is like an overcast one. The winds, southerly winds which are coming from behind pushing us, and generally North Sea is like this whenever I have transited, but for the past 15 days it was awesome sunny days. Hopefully the approach in Rotterdam would be a bit sunny, but yeah, that's the present wind conditions and weather conditions. Also, one of the best parts about Europe are the windmills which you will see right now just 5 miles off of us, and I will put a time lapse now which I made last time. You will see the night lapse of the windmills. We are here in the forward, and the wind is quite strong, as you can see the streaks
on the water. Got two tugs, one tug right over there, the tug line, and we got Natalie with us assisting us,
and the guys are on the spring lines, so we will have like additional lines today because it's pretty windy.
But let's go for the spring lines.
Okay.
Captain, heaving line ashore forward. So guys, I'll be operating the winch now and sending the two springs, and the two springs will be here. As you can see, there's the truck. We made the spring tights and now we will let go the tugs. Yeah,
this one, huh? Okay guys, so we are sending the tug now. Well, we have a strong lady there. Thank you, Natalie.
Also, Natalie is from the army, so we will cover her story very, very soon, guys. Stay tuned for the coming videos. As soon as we have come alongside, we have bunkering, and the bunker barge is here.
As you can see, it's being made fast, and that's the bunker hose.
So it's going to be another busy one in the ports.
The wind force, you can see, is increasing,
and as per the weather forecast, it is going to increase in the next 3-4 hours, so we need to keep an eye on the mooring stations at all times. So guys, whenever we are at port and bunkering, we need to make sure as a duty officer that these cuppers are closed, because if by chance there's an oil spill, we need to keep it contained on board, and for that we also have a pre-bunker meeting which we had yesterday. So yeah, that's how the procedure is. Guys, I have finally stepped ashore from where I signed on 15 days ago. And I wanted to show you all the unmanned vehicles which are
behind me right now. It's over there lined up somewhere. Yeah, those are the ones.
These are electronically controlled by people sitting ashore. Yeah, you can see right over. And it's only in the port of Rotterdam in the world. And they have sensors all around.
because of which they are able to, you can see, you just saw that it stopped and it waited for the other one to proceed. So that's how it is, that's how is the future of ports and shipping.
You can see over there, like, no drivers, nothing at all. Even the cranes which are operating and putting the containers on the driverless vehicle are unmanned. Basically everything is unmanned on this side of the jetty, everything. Okay, these are the camera and the sensors which are like operating this crane. So I just spoke to the foreman about these cranes and he told me like there's one operator each for the crane sitting at shore.
And he is controlling the main spreader, while there's another one controlling the spreader behind, putting it onto the trucks. The trucks are lined up over there, and once they are in demand, automatically they move from the position, circle around, and come for picking up or
discharging the cargo, whatever it is. And what happens is that
these trucks, when they are empty, they go into that bay and they pick up the container automatically.
Not exactly automatically, but there are people controlling them and they have sensors, so it is automatic. Anyway, it is automatic. Yeah, do let me know in the comment section if I'm saying anything wrong, but that's the thing. And this is the future of, I think, the world, automation.
Our fourth engineer on the bunker manifold, and
he's just relieving the motorman who is technically in charge here, and he will go inside and we will speak to him as to what his duties and responsibilities are during the bunker station.
We have a built-in pump here connected to the save all tray,
just in case we have an oil spill, so we can just take the built-in pump, put it in big drums.
And we have some rags just below this.
It's for MARPOL and pollution prevention. That is our motorman Richard, and Richard will be here on the bunker manifold. Yeah.
Yeah.
So how long, Richard?
How long? Until 2 o'clock. Kitna padega?
Till 2 o'clock. So guys, he has to be standby here and keep a lookout. Lookout, yeah.
Lookout.
Lookout all times. And he signed on with me in Rotterdam last time. Yeah?
So guys, we have the fourth engineer.
Ayush with me. On the port stay, we are doing bunkering like I showed you with the bunker barge. He was at the manifold, but right now let's ask him a few questions about what his roles and responsibilities are during the port stay. So Ayush.
Yeah, actually now I relieve the chief engineer. I have to monitor some few parameters like how much quantity we are getting now in tanks.
Okay.
And actually we have to monitor with this our flow rate and ask barge when we have to reduce the flow rate and when we have to increase the flow rate.
Correct.
Because at almost when it is going to 80%, we have to reduce the flow rate, and then I will go for mix sounding and we will compare the how much quantity we are getting, how much the barge is claiming.
Okay, it's the next day, and if you're wondering how we dispose of garbage,
this is how garbage is disposed of on the skip. So
we don't throw anything overboard. Everything is landed on shore with various quantities. This is the garbage skip behind me, and
we just discharge it from the monorail.
Guys, finally the weather is good, and I wanted to give you a good look of the automatic gantry cranes.
Better view is over here. Yeah. No one, like no one. And the entire terminal is automatic.
Full automation. So this could be the future of shipping. Anyway guys, so the last port in Europe is almost over now. And next we are headed to Port Tangimet. We'll have a 4 day sailing. Finally, I need some sailing. And now I will just go down and finish off my last working day on the port. Then it's working day at the sea, because yeah, it's much required. Although the weather is quite beautiful, but still I'm damn tired from the ports. It has been like 15 days straight since I signed on, so definitely need a break. So yesterday we put everything on manual because of the high winds, and today we have put it back on automatic tension since there's no wind and we put it on 50%, so the lines are just, you know, holding on automatically. So like I told you, when the ship is coming close by, we have to be at the mooring station, and that's the Tripoli getting alongside just in front of us, and we leave in another few hours. So one ship goes, the other comes in, and that's how life is on ports, on everywhere. I hope you all loved the time lapse of this beautiful
setting sun.
This was the automatic port,
and you can still see the cranes without any people inside, just the sensors and the cameras.
So do let me know your opinion of whether the entire shipping industry can be autonomous soon. Till then, do take care, and if you like the video, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you later.